The bones in the skull except the lower jaw bones do not allow any movement. The joints between the ribs and the breast bone allow only slight movement. Most of the joints in the human body are freely movable joints. These freely movable joints are of four main types, depending on the types of movement they allow. Hinge joint. There are so many joints are there. Let us talk about different joints. First, I want to tell you how many joints are given in this chapter. Hinge joint, ball and socket joint, pivot joint, gliding joint. Let us talk about hinge joint, okay? The elbow, knee, finger joint allow movement in one plane partially, that is up and down or backward and forward like the hinges of a door. Such joints are known as hinge joints. Okay, those joints are only help in a movement of bones up and down, back and forward, okay, from only one plane, then they are said to be hinge joint. Let us talk about another joint, ball and socket joint. The shoulder and hip joint allow movement in all direction. In such joints, the end of one of the bones is round like a ball. It's fit into hollow part in the other bones. For example, the femur or the humerus can move in any direction. Such a joint are said to be ball or socket, ball and socket joint. So ball and socket joints are shoulder and hip joints that allow to movement in all direction. Femur or humerus can move in any direction, and such joints are known as such joints are known as ball and socket joint. Let us talk about another type of joint, which is pivot joint. The neck joints also allow movement in all directions. It allows you to move your head up and down, right and left. Okay. Also it rotates, and in such joint one of the bone end in a round or conical surface fit into the dent in other bone, and such a joint is known as pivot joint. So pivot joint is also movable in all direction that help or allow to move our head up and down, right and left. Okay. Let us talk about another joint, which is gliding joint. The wrist or ankle joint have flattened ends of bones that can move against each other. These joints allow side to side as well as backward and forward movement. The vertebrae also have similar joints that allow slight movement, and such joints are called glide joint. See this one. Okay, this joint is allow side to side, backward and forward movement. Okay. So let us see all the types of joint. First of all, this is hinge joint. This is ball and socket joint. This is pivot joint. And this is gliding joint. Okay. Next topic is what makes the bones move. The bones cannot move by themselves. It is your muscle attached to the bones that make them move at the joints. Muscles are like elastic band. They are attached to the bones by means of tough connective band, which is known as tendons. So tendons is also a connective bones. The muscle move the bones by their pull, and muscles cannot push. Therefore, the move to move the bones in one direction, at least two set of muscles are required. Okay. For example, up and down movement of your arm is controlled by two muscles, biceps and triceps. When you want to raise your hand, the biceps in the front contract and they become shorter and fatter to pull up the arm. To the lower arm, the tricep at the back contract the pull. Okay, you can see this figure. Okay, this is one part and this is second part. This is bicep and this is tricep. In contraction, this bicep increases and this is decreases. In relaxation, both are equal. You can see the difference between bicep and tricep during contraction and during relaxation. Okay, so this can happen with the help of two muscles. One is biceps and second is triceps. When you run, your leg alternate bend and strains at the knee and ankle. Obviously, you can see this figure, how you can run. This is folded and then after this is folded. Okay, so one is folded and one is straight. You can also see some bones with the help of X-ray photographs that are given in your book. Okay. So for today, it is enough. You need to revise this chapter from page number 95 to 100. I repeat, read this chapter carefully, make notes. Read chapter 9 from page number 95 to 100. Okay, thank you.